Hello everyone! In this video, we will be covering chapter 5. So just to recap, in chapter 3, we looked at the goods market. In chapter 4, we looked at the financial markets. And now we will look at the goods and financial markets together. Revision chapter 3. Let's first summarize what we learned in chapter 3. We characterized equilibrium in the goods market as the condition that production Y be equal to the demand for goods Z. We call this condition the IS relation. We define demand as the sum of consumption, investment, and government spending. We assume that consumption was a function of disposable income, so that is income minus taxes, and took investment spending, government spending, and taxes as given. So we had Z is equal to C, Y minus T plus I bar plus G. The equilibrium condition was given by Y is equal to C, Y minus T plus I bar plus G. The assumption was that investment is constant. In the IS relation, we relax this assumption. Investment, sales, and interest rate. Investment depends on two factors, the level of sales and the interest rate. To capture these two effects, we write the investment relation as follows. So we say I is equal to I, YI, then we have a positive sign and a negative sign. This equation states that investment I depends on production Y and the interest rate I. The positive sign under Y indicates that an increase in production, equivalently an increase in sales, leads to an increase in investment. The negative sign under the interest rate I indicates that an increase in the interest rate leads to a decrease in investment. Therefore, the relationship, as output and income increases, the level of sales increases and investment rises. Or, an increase in the interest rate increases the cost of borrowing and investment declines. The level of sales. So the level of sales. Consider a firm facing an increase in sales and needing to increase production. To do so, it may need to buy additional machines or build additional plants. In other words, it needs to invest. The interest rate. Suppose a firm wants to buy a new machine. To do this, the firm must borrow. Capital investments are usually very large. Therefore, we assume all firms borrow at the same interest rate, namely the interest rate on bonds, and there is no distinction between nominal and real interest rate. If the interest rate is high enough, the additional profits from investments are not enough to cover interest payments, and firms do not invest. Determining output. Taking into account the investment relation we looked at earlier, the condition for equilibrium in the goods market becomes Y is equal to C, Y minus T plus I, YI plus G, and production again equals demand. The ZZ curve with flexible I. In short, an increase in output leads to an increase in the demand for goods through its effects on both consumption and investment. This relation between demand and output for a given interest rate is represented by the upward sloping ZZ curve. Note two characteristics of ZZ in this figure. Since we have not assumed that the consumption and investment relation in the previous slide or linear, ZZ in general is a curve rather than a line. Thus, we have drawn it as a curve in this figure. We have drawn ZZ so that it is flatter than the 45 degree line. Put another way, we have assumed that an increase in output leads to a less than 1-for-1 increase in demand. Equilibrium in the goods market is reached at the point where the demand for goods equals output, that is point A, which is the intersection of the ZZ and the 45 degree line. So it's this part. The equilibrium output level is given by Y. Also note, the intercept on the vertical axis is now only CO, or autonomous spending, and G, government spending. Deriving the IS curve. We have drawn the demand relation ZZ in the previous slide for a given value of the interest rate. Let's now derive a figure and see what happens if the interest rate changes. Let's name the first figure A and the figure below figure B. So this is figure A and this is figure B. Suppose that in figure A, the demand curve is given by ZZ and the initial equilibrium is at point A. Now, suppose that the interest rate increases from its initial value, I, to a higher value, I prime. At any level of output, the higher interest rate leads to lower investment and lower demand. The demand curve shifts down to ZZ prime. So it shifts down to ZZ prime. At a given level of output, demand is lower. The new equilibrium is at the intersection of the lower demand curve, ZZ prime, and the 45-degree line at point A prime. The equilibrium level of output is now equal to Y prime. Using figure A, we can find the equilibrium output associated with any value of the interest rate. The resulting relation between equilibrium output and the interest rate is drawn in figure B. The figure B plots equilibrium output Y on the horizontal axis and the interest rate on the vertical axis. Point A in figure B corresponds to point A in figure A, and point A prime in figure B corresponds to A prime in figure A. The higher interest rate is associated with lower level of output. The relation between interest rate and output is represented by the downward sloping curve in figure B, and this curve is called the IS curve. What does the IS curve represent? So the IS curve is all the equilibrium points of the goods market. Chain of events in the IS curve. There is an increase in the interest rate. More firms will decide not to invest because lending for the investment becomes too expensive. Investment then decreases, and that is a downward shift in the demand for goods. The level of income and output decreases, and as the level of income and output decreases, consumption, spending, and investment decline. Shifts in the IS curve. So for tax or government spending changes, assume taxes increase. At a given interest rate, an increase in taxes leads to a decrease in disposable income. A decrease in disposable income leads to a decrease in consumption. A decrease in consumption leads to a decrease in the demand for goods. And a decrease in the demand for goods leads to a decrease in output. So this figure shows what was explained in the previous slide. And here you can see that an increase in taxes shifts the IS curve to the left. And then this is just a recap.